Hi, welcome back on my YouTube channel. In today's video, I'm going to review the Q plugin for QGIS. Q is the AI chatbot which you can use to interact with prompts with QGIS. It's developed by Bunting Labs, the same guys that developed the AI vectorizer plugin, which is also in another video on my YouTube channel. And in this video, we're going to have a look at what Q can do for us. So it claims that it can translate plain English into SQL expressions, which means you can write a prompt in plain English and it will execute a selection of features. You can filter layers or you can use fields or expressions. There are tutorial videos available. If you add something complex, it will create a chain of actions. You can download OpenStreetMap features easily with prompts, and you can do the styling of layers. Here's a video with installation instructions, but I'll guide you through that. And you can try that. The first month is free, and then you have to pay. You can install it from the plugins manager. And as I said, it can be used for editing vectors, symbology, searching data sets, adding base maps, and running geoprocessing algorithms and some other tasks. And if it cannot do the task directly, you will see that it also will give you the steps to do it manually. So let's install the plugin from the plugins manager. Search for Q. And if you click the homepage button there, you'll see the page that I showed just before. And click install plugin to install it. It doesn't need any further actions on dependencies, and it's installed. After installation of the plugin, you will find this bird icon, and if you click it, it will open the QAI assistant that you can use to chat. But before we can use it, we need to log in, and you can use your email address and follow the steps provided by the website to be able to use the chat functionality of Q. Now we're ready to give prompts. So first, I would like to see a world map, and it loads an OpenStreetMap base map. And then I would like to have the country boundary polygon of the Netherlands. Here it got itself a bit stuck by the query on OSM. I'm not sure if it's my network, but let's try something else. Maybe it was the search extent, so let's zoom in. And I'm going to focus on Groningen in the Netherlands. So can you add the municipality of Groningen? It goes again to OSM to do a query, and it adds here the municipality boundary. I'm surprised to see that it's a line. I would expect a polygon. Maybe I should have specified that. But let's see how we solve that later. I'll ask to make it more visible. Can you style it with a thick red line? And here you see it does. Can you add the building footprints of Groningen? It does an OSM query, and here the buildings appear, so that works. I would like to clip those building footprints to the municipality polygon, but I have lines, so I ask if it can provide the polygon. That's great, and can it now also clip the buildings to the municipality polygon? That works great, but now I want to get rid of the original building footprints, so I ask if it can remove it from the layers panel. As you see, it hides it, it does not remove it. Let's see how far we can get with styling. I would like to see an inverted polygon shape burst fill. Unfortunately, that's not possible, so let's style it with a thick red line and no fill. And that works. Let's add some more data. Can you add the water bodies inside the municipality polygon? It does an OSM query, and indeed it returns the water bodies. Can you clip the water polygons to the boundary polygon of the municipality and remove the original layer? It only did the first action. Can you rename the clipped layer to water bodies? Because it only creates temporary layers. It did it. Can you hide the water bodies in the Groningen layer? And it also hides that one. So now we have a nice view on the area. Can you style the water bodies with a light blue? It does. Can you add the roads of the municipality of Groningen? And it adds the layers from OpenStreetMap. Can you style the road types differently? And it sets categorize symbol, and we can see the result there. Can you find the locations where the roads cross water bodies? And let's check what it found. And we see there indeed that we have the bridges and tunnels. Can you rename the last layer to bridges and tunnels? It did that. Can you add all parkings in Groningen? It does an OSM query. And now the parkings are added. Can you style them with a gray fill and black outline? Yes, it can. Note that it adds some transparency. Which parkings are closest to the railway station? It says that it needs the location of the station, so can you add the station of Groningen as a point? It does an OSM query, and indeed it finds the station. Can you style it with an SVG marker suitable for a station? Unfortunately, it only returns some code instead of styling it. Can you create the centroids of the parking polygons? It does. As you see, I tried to do the buffers and it adds some buffers, but these were of course wrong because the downloaded layers from OpenStreetMap were in the geographic coordinate system. So later in this video, you'll see the reprojection. My next question is if it can dissolve the water bodies layer, because I see those lines. And it says, well, you don't give an attribute, so do I need to dissolve all? So I explained that it should dissolve all the water body polygons. Then I asked to rename the result, and I asked to copy the style of the water body's original layer to the dissolved one. It says it can't do it, but it gives me instructions to do it manually, so that's what I do here. Then it would be nice to see the name, so can you label the original water body's layer with the names? And it complains that it doesn't see a clear name attribute, so it's going to use the name attribute. That's a bit weird, but it does the job. Until now, we've been working with those layers downloaded from OpenStreetMap in the geographic coordinate system. So, can you reproject the following layers to the EPSG 28992, the Dutch projection, building footprints, centroids, and the water bodies dissolved? And here it's going to do it, indeed. It reprojects the layers. So that's pretty cool. And there we see the result. And it explains what it did. It's not so useful that these layers are called reprojected. So can you rename each layer so it reflects the data it represents better? And indeed it did it. And it also explains how to do it manually if I would not agree with the result. Can you create a buffer of 100 meters around the centroid EPSG 28992 layer? And that works. It would be nicer to see a dissolved result. So can you dissolve these buffers into one polygon? That also works. Can you make the buffers transparent? I'm not sure what it did. It seems it made it transparent, a little bit transparent. So I'm gonna hide the layer below and at least I can see the buffer, but it doesn't go all the way through. But let's continue. Can you find the buildings that are inside the dissolved buffers layer? So we know which buildings are within 100 meters of the parking. And it says it needs a intersection, spatial operation. And it tries something here, but I don't really understand that result. So this needs some further attention. With all these layers generated, it would be nice to have them all stored in one GeoPackage. So I'll ask, can you save all layers in a GeoPackage? Start processing and it says package layers completed. And then I get some verbal results that all the selected layers have been successfully saved into a GeoPackage, that I can find it in this path, and that there are layers saved with these names, and it advises me to make the layers permanent. So I think in conclusion, this plugin works very well. Need some trial and error and to tune your prompts to get the right results. And yeah, looking forward to see more things coming up with GeoAI. If you want to see more, please subscribe to my YouTube channel and I'll keep you posted.